It looks like just from here, from what I can see, is that they're telling her to get her the clinch and uppercut her and uppercut her. Keep her busy, and then when she starts to commit, to get the takedown. Now, Zoila's corner should be telling her to circle, stay away, and strike. Keep long range, jab, use that jab, pump it out, land the right hand, and finish off with the kick.
Two very close rounds. Round two underway.
I kind of see the last round maybe possibly going to Zoila because she landed the first two big head kicks in the first part of the round. Head kicks are pretty big in any sport. But she needs to set it up. She's only kicking right now. She's not punching. But here she goes. She's getting pushed against the cage.
Karina, at this point, she's not as afraid of the kicks as she was early on. She's found a way to absorb most of the blows where it's not actually hurting her.
Well, what Zoila needs to do is work for the underhooks so she can stay away. There, nice elbow. She needs to work for those underhooks so she can stay out of that headlock position. She's got that tie headlock position, which is possibly getting her taken down because Karina's looking to get the body lock and get the easy takedown.
Zoila needs to get out now.
Yeah.
She needs to get out.
She's got her back now, pulled her down to the ground. It looks like she's going to end up on bottom.
That was just a position in the fall down, basically, because she's got this
nice reverse. Oh. Karina technically still has her back. Zoila's landing the punches. If Karina circles out, she could possibly get to her back. Nice move, though. Beautiful. She's on top.
This is real important at this stage of this fight, I'm positive.
What? She's really landing some good punches from the top, it looks like.
Trying to get a full mount here.
Looks like she's getting. She's looking. Looks like she might get caught in an arm bar. She wants to drop those shoulders back inside, get her shoulders back cleared away from her legs. The worst thing to do right now is to try and pull out. She needs to look the posture up. Zoila needs to look the posture up and land some good strikes.
30 seconds left in round one. Going for a lift.
Karina should be looking to hit those submission attempts as fast as possible.
We've got about 10 seconds left in this third round.
Those were some big knees late in the fight. A Buhawi trademark. There you have it. End of the fight.
Fight of the night.
I think so far.
Very exciting fight, Josh, I got to tell you. It's going to be a tough one for the judges.
It's a tough one to judge. Definitely have to agree with you. Zoila finished off a lot stronger than I thought she was gonna. So it'll be interesting to see what happens how the judges come out. You just never know. You never know what the judging criteria is gonna be from stand up to whether the judges are looking for the stand up. If the stand up punches landed cleanly, if the submission attempts and the takedowns were clean. I mean, you never know what they're looking for. I thought she kicked well, but she didn't put her hands and her feet together very well. You know, she clinched well.
Let's go to the ring and get a decision.
Now, after three exciting rounds, judge number one scores the bout 29-28, Helena.
We're going to have a split decision.
Judge number two scores the bout 29-28, Frosto. Judge number three scores the bout 29